World record holder is in line to get his second gold of these games after taking gold in the 100 earlier. He has not lost this race at a major international meet since he took silver behind Lenny 4 years ago in Sydney. The lane assignments. Lane one, Blaž Medvesek of Slovenia. Slovenia has never won an Olympic swimming medal. In lane two, it's Gregor Tate. Two swimmers from Great Britain in this final. It has been nearly 100 years since the country last won a medal in either backstrokes. Marcus Rogan is in lane three, and he represents the biggest threat to Pearsall. Born and raised in Austria, but has lived in the United States since the age of 14. And Pearsall, who calls this 200 back my baby, wants to make sure he nails down the gold tonight. Next to him in lane five is the other man from Great Britain, James Goddard. And we talked about the history involved here concerning Great Britain. Rosvan Floria of Romania in lane six, the silver medalist at the European Championships. Simone Dufour of France is in lane seven, the bronze medalist at the Europeans. And Tomomi Morita of Japan is in lane eight. Japan has never won a medal in this event. Rowdy, this is Pearsall's race as he gets set to go four lengths of the pool.
Well, you know, Dan, the hardest thing, though, to do in swimming in the Olympic Games, in my opinion, is to come in as the favorite and actually win the race. And he's such an overwhelming favorite, sort of like what we're going to see from Michael Phelps in the 200 IM. And that's going to be tough to do. If he swims his race, nobody's going to be close, though.
There he is in lane four. Just above him is Rogan from Austria. And the way he put it earlier, Roddy, was almost as if Pearsall has to really, really be off, and Rogan has to really, really race the race of his life, practically.
It's like he's going to have to miss every turn. He's going to have to be poor on his finish. The legs are going to have to die, and everything's going to have to fall in place perfectly. For Marcus Rogan, you can see up here, up there in lane number three, right next to Aaron Pearsall. So that's good for Rogan because he can see him the whole way, but it's also good for Pearsall because he's got a bird's eye view of him.
Pearsall with a lead, just slightly under world record pace. And second was Goddard below Pearsall in lane five after that first turn.
And I thought Aaron Pearsall might have jumped on it a little early in the semifinals. Looks like he's settling down here and just kind of building each 50. Remember, he's got the three fastest times in history. He just has the right blend of speed and endurance and power to be able to just pump this race and get it going on this third 50. And you can see he's starting to increase his tempo a little bit, Dan, right there. Although, you know what? They're hanging in there. They're hanging in there. Goddard, though, you know he's going to fade a little bit. I don't expect him to be able to stay with Pearsall the last 50, but Rogan will be able to be tough, and he'll hang in there that last 50. Rogan's right above him, hugging that lane line, trying to catch as much of a draft as possible off of Pearsall.
Rogan just above him, Goddard just below him. Pearsall looks like he's set to win another Olympic gold, just over the world record pace, but Pearsall pulling away with that easy, loping stroke.
Oh,
he's got
boy.
A full body length lead on the field.
Oh,
Aaron
boy.
Pearsall is close to the world record, but it's drifting away from him, that line. So that's going to get the world record. But Aaron Pearsall is going to absolutely cruise into the wall for his second gold medal of these games and a new Olympic record. Rogan took the silver, and Rosvan Floria of Romania took the bronze. We knew it was going to be easy, but not that easy.
A stroll in the park. Wow, that's the second fastest time in history. Now he has the fourth fastest. Nobody even close to him. He just swam that race perfectly, too. Great strategy there by building that first 100 and then just jumped on it from there. But watch his start. He keeps everything so nice and tight and tucked closely, and then he springs off those blocks. You see him spring off like a cat, and then he throws that head back, and watch this underwater version of the start. Boy, I tell you what. And then he pops to the surface so well. And in third turn is where he made the huge move. You see him right there, flip turning on that stomach, coming off that wall. Biceps really squeezed hard against those back of the ears. And then when he finishes, it's just, he just makes it look so easy.
Pearsall in line for triple gold, already has swept the backstroke events here, and he's got the medley relay Saturday night, in which the Americans are favored as well. such a great tradition of backstrokers of the United States through the years.
Hold on, just a second. Something is going on. The board is not official yet or something.
We're getting word that a disqualification has been made by a judge saying that Pearsall made an illegal turn on the final turn.
Incredible.
He says, what's happening here? What's the deal with a turn here, Rowdy?
Well, we just looked at it a second ago, and I didn't see anything there. There's nothing there. That looks fine. He comes off the wall. And I don't see anything there, Dan, to indicate any problem whatsoever.
Well, then what is the deal here?
That's unfair.
That is Marcus Rogan, the man that finished second, saying he ought to protest it. And you can hear the crowd whistling, and Pearsall's trying to rile them up to get involved.
Well, when you go into a turn and backstroke, there has to be a continuous motion. Apparently, what the officials are saying is that Pearsall stalled or stayed on his stomach too long, I guess. But I did not see anything there. That's a ridiculous call. Watch, you flip over in your stomach. You continue making that motion into the wall. You come off the wall. That is a bogus call. If indeed that is the call, that is ridiculous.
And you can hear the crowd really shouting their disapproval. And now we understand that the United States is going to file a protest on the DQ. Pearsall's not talking to anybody about it as he brushes by the media there. The judges are still talking about this whole thing.
Wow.
We're going to try to sort it out when we come back. Pearsall being told by his U.S. coaches that everything is now okay. He's been reinstated as the gold medalist. There it is on the board. Now, the disqualification was overturned because it was improperly filed in a couple of ways. First, it was not communicated in English, which is required by the rules. And there's the judge. The verbal explanation given by him to the meet committee didn't match the original written one. So Pearsall, after waiting the whole thing out, is officially the champion. Let's go down to Melissa.
Well, he has a smile on his face now, but what an emotional roller coaster for Aaron Pearsall. You thought you'd won gold, then you were told no. What was your reaction when you found out the gold was indeed yours?
I don't know. It was a roller coaster, you know, and I was absolutely elated. The guys who swam with me, and especially Marcus, were pretty good about it, you know, and I think they understood. And I feel sorry for the emotional roller coaster for the guys as well, because they were bumped up a medal too, and then they were pushed back down, and that takes a whole toll on the whole field, you know. So,
what were you thinking when they told you you were disqualified?
Honestly, I wasn't too worried about it, and I mean I was, in the sense that, like, you know, I totally blew me away, but not even through my head could I remember what I had done wrong. But my coaches did a great job reviewing the tapes, and they made a great argument, and you know, all's good and well now. So
does all this drama make this gold more special?
Yeah, it does, because you know, this is a dream, man, and it certainly was a trip, you know. It was a little twisted. It was twisted, but it was fun.
I know your parents cried and cried after you won gold in 100. What do you think they're doing now?
I know what they were doing, and they were. I'm sure it's been more of a roller coaster for them, you know. It's a lot harder to sit in the stands and watch, you know, than it is to be down here. I know they're happy now, you know. And I'm very proud, and I'm very happy.
Big sigh of relief, I'm sure, for all involved. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
So here are the final official standings. Pearsall by nearly 2.5 seconds over Rogan, and remaining is Razvan Floria took the bronze. But this is ironic that Pearsall is involved with this tonight. He was the guy, if you might remember, who was openly accusing Japan less than an